It's not getting recorded. Okay, there you go. Sorry, yes, now it goes. Actually, I got disconnected, so I didn't realize. Okay. So yes, guys, when you create the account on AdWords, these are the settings that you make first at the account level. That means it includes billing information. You have to select the currency while setting up an account. This cannot be changed later, guys. You can select the currency, okay? So if you are dealing in dollars, if you are paying in dollar or running a campaign, then you can select currency, and if not in INR, then you can select Indian rupee. After that, once you set the billing information, set the account level settings, which includes notification settings, preference settings, and time zone settings, guys. Notification settings, preference settings, you can change later, but not the time zone setting, guys. And time zone option cannot, as I said, time zone option is not cannot be changed later on. So you also have to make sure that the time zone you're setting, it has to be set same at the account level, server level, and analytics, guys. Account is Google AdWords account. The time zone that you're setting, server, your system, like your computer system, time zone has to be similar, and the Google Analytics. So when you register or start analytics, the time zone which you have set here at the Google AdWords, make sure you set the same time so that you get the reporting in sync. Okay, there will be consistency in the data that you're going to get. Clear, guys? Account settings. Then, guys, you will have campaign. Within account, you will create a campaign. And at the campaign level, guys, you can set all these settings, like the type of ad that you want to create, whether search ad or display ad, different type of ads you can select. Device type, like where you want to showcase your advertisement, okay? Devices like mobile, tablet, computer. So guys, this in search ad, when you create search ads, you cannot change device types. But if you're creating a display ad, then definitely you can change or edit the device where you want to showcase the advertisement. The next option, guys, is the location. You can select the location where you want to showcase the advertisement, and you will set the bid and the budget settings at the campaign level. The amount that you are willing to bid and the daily budget. What's your daily budget? That will be set at the campaign level, guys. Okay. And if you are when you're creating a campaign, guys, in order to create number of ad drops, you have to see all the ad drops that you are creating. For that ad group, you need to have the same location, okay, which will be set at the campaign setting for different location. Let's say for 3 BHK here, if I'm talking about 2 BHK apartment, 3 BHK apartment, you cannot target different audience here, guys. The audience will remain same. Okay, if you want to change the audience, then you have to create a new campaign altogether. A new campaign will be created. But if your set of audience location remains same, in that case, you can create different ad groups. Okay, clear, guys? Shivam, Vinu, are you with me? Can you hear me? Is it clear? Okay. So after keywords, let's say after campaign, you will have ad groups. Within each campaign, guys, you can have number of ad groups, and for each ad group, you can have set of keywords. Campaign runs with different keywords, but with one campaign, you can have different ad groups, we know, and within each ad group, you can have different set of keywords. Different set of keywords you can use. clear? See, campaign here, let's say I'm creating an account, okay? I want to start creating, I want to run an advertisement for my real estate business, okay? And I'm into residential and commercial both. This hypothetical example that I'm taking. So when I create a campaign, okay, there I mentioned this campaign I'm creating for residential because my residential, the audience that I'm going to target, the location I'm going to target is different for commercial. Okay, that's the reason I'm creating two campaigns, one for residential and the other is for commercial. So here within residential, I can have number of ad groups, okay, because for 2 BHK apartment, 3 BHK apartment, 4 BHK apartment, my keywords will be different, okay? So if anyone search for buy 2 BHK apartment, then my this ad copy will showcase from this ad group. And if anyone searches for 3 BHK apartment, then these keywords will showcase like buy 3 BHK property in Noida. These are all my keywords. And based on these keywords, my ad copy will showcase. So here you can see this campaign I have created is for residential, first thing. Second thing, that the ad group I have created is for 2 BHK apartment in residential, 3 BHK apartment, 4 BHK apartment. Okay, and for 2 BHK apartment, I have different set of keywords and different ad copy will showcase. For ad group 2, where I have target 3 BHK apartment. So each tab will have different keywords in a website. Exactly, each web page will have set of keywords in a website. That is for SEO you are asking. That is for SEO purpose basically. Every time, yes, this is SEO purpose. When you are doing SEO also of your website, for each web page you are going to mention different set of keywords in your website, okay? But here what I'm talking is a bit different. Here I'm talking about an ad campaign. For 2 BHK, a different set of keywords, you can understand. Like in practical also, if anyone search for buy 2 BHK apartment, I don't want to showcase them 3 BHK ad copy. I will only show them 2 BHK copy, ad copy. Okay. Venu, is it getting clear now? Yes, each subdivision is a separate ad. But the amount that we are paying, like the budget will remain same. Everything will remain same. The location will remain same. Devices we have selected remain same. Only the targeting option will change, okay? And at the ad group level, we can also specify bid. For each ad group, we can have different bid also, like the amount. For example here, if for 2 BHK apartment, I can bid for, let's say, 100 rupees, okay? And for ad group 3, like say 3 BHK apartment, I can bid 150. Let's say people are looking, this is highly, if this is more competitive, then I have to bid high price here. And here I can bid like 120 rupees. For each ad group, I can bid different amount. If anyone searches on this keyword, buy 2 BHK apartment, and my ad copy will showcase, and if they click, I will be charged 100 rupees for that. 100 rupees for that. And for example, if anyone searches for 3 BHK apartment and this ad copy will appear, and if they click, then I will be charged 150 rupees. So at each ad group, for different keywords, set of keywords, I can bid different amount. Clear, guys. Shivam and Vino, is it getting clear? Okay, great, Shivam. And Vino, how about you? Yes, guys, it will get more clear when we do practical. This is just the theoretical information I'm giving you to make you understand easily when we do practical things, and things will get more clear when we do actual practical. Okay, so let me just come back on this PPT, guys, here. This is the campaign level settings that we do here. So this is one example which you can see account one. When the account is created, these two campaigns we have created where we have set the targeted option is search network. This campaign we are creating for search network, which is for Google. And this is for display network, which is the partner website of Google. Then we set the desktop and mobile devices here. And here we set all devices. Okay, and here the location we have selected is LA, which is Los Angeles. And here we have selected the location that is London. And the budget for this is $500 per day. And here the budget is $100 per day. Okay, these are the level of settings that we do at campaign level. Moving ahead, this is the ad group level settings that we do, where we define the set of keywords. Okay, at each ad group, we are going to tell the keywords and the ad copy. So if anyone search with learn PPC, this ad copy will showcase. And if anyone searches for study PPC, the same ad copy will showcase. Okay, and if now anyone searches, this is the different ad group one, ad group two. Here the keywords are Google SEO and Bing SEO. And if anyone searches for Google SEO, this ad copy will showcase. If anyone searches with Bing SEO, this ad copy will showcase. Okay, and keywords and ads need to be related, guys. You can have multiple unrelated ad groups under a campaign. Like you can have unrelated ad groups, like number of ad groups you can create with different set of keywords and different ad copies, right, within one campaign. Make sense? Clear, guys? Ad position, guys, I have told you. If you want to revise, yes, great. So, guys, how you calculate the ad rank? Okay, so to look. Get the ad rank, there are number of things which are dependent, okay, for ad rank. Ad rank is actually the position, okay, where you are going to be ranked. So these are the positions, guys, how they are ranking, number 5, 6, 7, these are the ad ranks, okay. And how you are going to rank like number one on Google. So there is the formula for that. The first thing which is dependent here is, guys, the bid, the amount you are going to bid for keywords, okay? Second is the quality score, guys. So as I told you, quality score depends on number of things, three things basically. One is the relevancy of the landing page, where your audience will land. When they click on your ad copy, where they will land, that can be your website or any other page, okay? Web page of your website basically. So the relevancy of landing page will be checked, then ad copy. Ad copy is the content of your ad. This is the ad copy, the content. Okay, and so when I click here, I will land on this website page that is my landing page. This is the landing page, guys. Okay, so Google will check the landing page. Google will check the ad copy, whether they all are related or not. The third thing is the CTR, guys, which is click through rate. Okay, and this is calculated in percentage here. That means number of impressions. Exactly. Yes, we know landing page is the website divided by number of clicks. Guys, you're clear about click-through rate, CTR? And this is in percentage, guys. So let's say for this ad, I have got 100 impressions, but I have got 10 clicks. Okay, so what would be my CTR? 10%. Yes? Then, guys, quality score, and then we have ad extension, guys. What is ad extension? So guys, when we create ad, and this is the space that we get, like where we give the headline, okay, and we give the destination URL, and we give the description, okay. This space is limited, right? So here, as you see, these are all ad extensions where we can give the links of our website. Okay, if you give all these extensions, like you can give these extensions, you can give a mobile number as an extension, you can give location as an extension. There are a number of extensions which are available, which we are going to talk about later when we actually are on the creation of ad copy. Okay. So if you add this on your ad copy, then it really, Google really values this. If you give the ad extensions, then Google really values this. And 20% of this weightage is carried by ad extension, and quality score is 80% weightage. Okay. So if I show you here, AdRank is the algorithm used by search engine to rank PPC ads, like pay-per-click ads. Search engine determines ad rank using the following components, like maximum bid, like the amount you bid. Second is the quality score, and third is the ad extension. Okay. So this is the formula, which is ad rank equals maximum bid, the bid that you have given for the keyword, into quality score plus ad extension. And quality score weightage is 80% and ad extension weightage is 20%. Okay, and then based on this formula, your ad rank is decided by Google. Okay, so for example, here your bid is 1% and Google has given you quality score. This is the quality score and this is the ad extension score and this is your ad rank. It doesn't matter how much you are bidding. Okay. Just a second. So if you are, let's say, your info, like based on my info, I've got 6th ad rank and competitor has got this rank and competitor 2 has got this rank. And based on this rank, I've got 1st position, 2nd position and 3rd position. Clear, guys? And you can see that competitor 2 is paying highest amount for the bid, right? But still competitor 2 has got 3rd position because the quality score and ad extension score is low. So ad rank goes down. Clear, guys? Make sense? Meenu, is it clear? Number of impressions. Number of impression means the number of people who have come on this, who has searched on this keyword and viewed, like just have a glance of my ad copy. Glance of my ad copy. Right? So if I came here, diamond jewelry, I got to view this ad copy, but I haven't clicked. It's just the impression I have got. Okay? Clear now, Venu? Great. Okay, let's just move ahead. So then quality score, as I told you, quality score depends on the click-through rate, ad relevancy, and landing page relevancy. Quality score fluctuates when the auction occurs. Quality score will keep fluctuating. It will not remain standard, okay? Because at particular location, might be people looking for those keywords and your CTR is higher. Based on your CTR, your quality score will also go up, okay? And at particular time duration also, your quality score can go up and probably at different time, your quality score can come down. Okay, so quality score may differ based on the following, like on devices such as mobile phone versus a desktop. Because at desktop, probably your ad copy is more, more appealing something, or on mobile phone it might not be that thing. People are not clicking on your ad copy, and at different times, say noon or versus midnight, as I told you, your quality score again can vary, because probably at midnight you're getting more clicks. More a click means your CTR is getting higher. Okay, the percentage of CTR is getting higher, so you're getting good quality score. Okay. For different geographic locations such as London and versus Los Angeles also, probably London people might be looking for your keywords, like your ad copy, and clicking on that ad copy, which is increasing your CTR, and the same thing is not happening in LA, due to which your quality score goes down here and goes up at London. Clear? So what's the need for ad rank? It is very important. Ad rank helps search engines order the ads on search result pages. Okay. The first thing, the ad rank will help the search engine to rank your website or give the position to your ad copy. Like one position, two position, third position. Then quality score forces advertisers to create ads that are relevant to users. Okay. If the quality of the ad copy is not good, landing page is not good, then definitely your ad copy will not showcase. If it is good, then definitely, like it, you know, motivates people to give a relevant ad copy and relevant landing page quality score. Okay. Users who click relevant ad get great results and become customers. So users who click relevant ads get great results and become customers. Definitely, if you are giving relevant ads, then you are going to get good results. And if the CTR increases, then definitely you will have customers. Okay. Paid search focuses on displaying relevant ads to the searcher. Paid search, so definitely, obviously, paid ads. Focus, this gives the focus on displaying relevant ads to the searcher, because if searcher comes and they don't find relevant ads, then they will not trust that medium, the search engine. If they find relevant ads, then definitely they will focus on that particular engine. Relevance increase the click-through rate for ads, which generates revenue for search engines. Right, so if click-through rate goes up, that means number of clicks are increasing, and if number of clicks are increasing, then search engine is making good amount of money because on every click they are charging. So that is good because they are making revenue out of that. Clear? And here, this is the example. This site, users who come on the search engine look for the information and they get to see this ad, they will get the result, they will become the customer. So this is the cycle. And you can see here, advertiser A, there are two advertisers. One is the advertiser A and the other is the advertiser B. Advertiser 0.5 on the keywords where advertiser B is paying, you know, like double the rate. And this on this advertiser A has got 50% of the CTR. They have got number of clicks, 50% of the clicks. And this advertiser has got just 10% of the clicks. You can see the total ad spend. This person has spent $2.5, whereas this person has spent, let's say, only $1, and they have got 10 clicks only, and this has got 50 clicks, 5 times, and just paying $1 more. On paying couple of dollar more, but 5 times clicks. Clear, guys? Menu, is it clear? There is no one else apart from you, so. Ad rank is clear, Venu. There, can you hear me? No, it's not clear. Is it not clear, Venu? Or it's clear? Not clear. Okay. Not a problem. So ad rank is not clear. Which part? Okay, ad rank is not clear, not a problem. So here, based on the ad rank, your position will be decided. So as I told you, your ad rank will depend on 3 things, bid, quality score, and ad extension. Bid is the amount that you are going to pay for the keywords. Okay, the amount that you are going to pay on every click. That is the bid. Second is the quality score, which carries the weightage of 80%. We know it carries weightage of 80%. And within quality score, Google is going to check the landing page of your, where you are routing your audience when they click. So when they click, they will land on your website. So that is your landing page. B is the ad copy, the content of your ad copy. Okay. This is the ad copy content. Third is the ad extension. So as I told you, these are the ad extensions. So when we create the ad at the Google AdWords, we get an option to mention the ad extensions. So these are the site links that we have given here. They have given. So when they click, when any user clicks on these site links, they will land on the website page, on the particular page of the website. Okay. So these are the number of ad extensions which are available, like You can give call extension where you can mention your mobile number. You can give the location extension where you can give the location of your business, the address, okay, and the site links you can give. If you add this ad extension, it will increase the value of the ad copy, okay? This Google really values. This means you are genuine. You are genuinely giving these ad extension, your ad copy is true. So this carries weightage of 20%. 20%. Okay, and this is the algorithm which Google use here, where you bid the maximum bid into quality score plus ad extensions. So the quality score is given by Google only, and the ad extension also given, the score is given by Google only. What's Venu, can you hear me? Me? Okay, great. So yes, I was telling you about ad rank. So your ad rank will depend on the maximum bid and quality score plus ad extension. Okay, quality score carries 80% of the weightage and ad extension carries 20% of the weightage. So this is the amount that we bid. Quality score is given by Google only based on the criteria that we have already discussed, and the ad extension score also. And this ad rank is calculated based on these figures. And when they get the ad rank, the position of the ad copy is decided. Is it clear now, Venu? Or you still have any doubt? Venu, is it clear or still you have any doubt? Venu, can you hear me? Venu, is it clear? Now let me just unmute you. Can you unmute yourself? Is ad rank is clear? Venu, can you hear me? I hope, is it all good? Is there any network issue? Are you facing some network related issue? Vinu, are you facing some network related issue? Please type it in the chat window. Vino, can you hear me? Venu, can you hear me? I'm calling you. Can you please take up the call? Please type it in the chat window.